Right then, I've got some exciting news. A while back I mentioned I had bought a 5.25-inch floppy drive on eBay from a seller in the UK and that I returned it, and that it took quite a lot of effort to get the money back through PayPal, so I was kind of fed up with them. But I now have some exciting news. I now have a 5.25-inch drive, a high density one, and it's working with my Pentium 2 computer. Yes, I bought this one at a specialist shop in the Netherlands, and it was a lot cheaper than eBay. This drive is a JData JD380 Model B. It's a high density drive, and this is the 1736 design variant of it, and that's important because there are many different versions of this particular drive. The JD380 is the drive that IBM originally used in their PC80 line of computers, and there exist single speed and dual speed versions of it. This is a single speed version. It's basically an enhanced version of the 1711 model. I will get to that a bit later when I'm going to look through some technical documents kind of explaining the different model variants. But there also exist double speed models that also have a 40 track option. That's a little bit technical because there's a lot of things to say about 5.25-inch drives. But anyway, there are early models that have termination resistor packs in them, and then there's the later models that don't have this. And this later model is easier to connect because you don't have to worry about those resistor packs. It's basically like a 3.5-inch drive. It automatically terminates the signal if necessary. Let's first take a look at the drive. So this here is the front of the unit. As you can see, it looks like a drive from an IBM model. And some JD380s actually have a sticker on them that says manufactured for IBM. But this is not one of those. This is just a generic one that you could buy off the shelf. So yeah, let's have a look. Here's the disk that I had inserted, Dr. Halo 3. This is a program, a really old graphics package that you got with a Genius mouse. It's a very old disk. This is, by the way, a double density disk. And there are some like forum posts on some old computer forum that say that this particular type of drive doesn't read double density. Well, that's nonsense because it reads them just fine. Apparently there was some issue with the JD380C model, but this is a JD380B. So that's the front, and to show the back I will have to disconnect it. Temporarily I have set it up like this with the 3.5-inch drive to a cable, and I've, well, got the cable from the same shop. Here I have two 3.5-inch drives in a black conversion bay. I have temporarily disconnected those. So, and everything now kind of buggers off to this universal floppy ribbon cable. It has connectors for both 5.25-inch and 3.5-inch drives on them. And of course it has the twist in the right place. Very important. Let me disconnect the drive so that I can show the back. And what I really like about 5.25-inch drives are these edge connectors. I find them a lot more pleasant to deal with than those IDC connectors that 3.5-inch drives use. I think these connectors are much more robust and just a lot friendlier. So this is the back of the unit. As it says, it is the JD380B model 1736. And this one was made in 1991. So this is one of the later models. The earlier models from IBM might be the 1711 model, and sometimes they have a sticker saying manufactured for IBM Corporation. So let's take a look at this in detail. Right, as you can see, there are only two jumper settings here, DS0 and DS1. With a PC you should always set it to DS1, and as you can see there are solder pads for DS3 and DS4. But you don't have to worry about those. This is here the DS0 jumper, and that's the DS1 jumper. And as you can see, there is no termination pack or termination jumper. It's hardwired, and apparently it uses the same kind of totem pole mechanism that 3.5-inch drives use, which is very nice and very convenient. Yeah, there you can see the DS select jumpers. odd thing is DS2 and DS3 are not connected, and they don't have any relevance on PCs. And as you can see, the jumper is set to DS1, which you should always set it to on PCs. On other systems, on non-IBM compatible systems like Acorn machines, you might have to set it to DS0 if you want to use it as a primary drive. So that's the mechanism. Here is the head. This is an 80 track head, because that's what high density drives use. And there is the nice clunky spring mechanism. And here's the stepper motor. And the stepper motor is quite, well, yeah, noisy as usual. They make their typical noises. So let's take a look at the back here. This is the model identification number. This is the JD380B. Model variant 1736. And this is one of the later models from the early 90s. Older models, like the JD380, like the 1711 type, they may actually have a termination resistor pack in them that is removable. So yeah, you could come across many different variants of this particular drive. I have some documents that I found on the internet, some service manuals that explain some of the differences, and this particular one is not really covered there. But yeah, this is just a single speed drive intended for IBM systems. But be aware that there also exist dual speed drives for Texas Instruments, and they apparently have like a 40 track option and an option where the rotation speed can be set to 300 RPM, just like in a double density drive, because they always run at 300 RPM and a high density one runs at 360 RPM. So that's something to take into account. But before I'm going to install this properly in the system, I of course first have to make some disk images. So I got a box of disks here. I've already copied the PC disks to the hard drive, and well, there's a lot here. I also found a lot of my old BASIC programs that I've rescued. But that's not all, because I also have a copy of Turbo Pascal. This here are Turbo Pascal disks. This is version 5.5. A neighbor of mine gave these to me like 20 years ago, so it's actually really nice to have this. But another reason why I bought this drive is because I want to make disk images of BBC micro floppies. They are in this case. And what I have here are actually PC disks with my own BASIC programs from like 20 years ago when I made games. But here is where the BBC micro disks start. Luckily, there's not too many of them, but just a few. Yeah, I'll need to use OmniFlop to make images of those. But for that, I have to install that drive in that Pentium 4 system. I've already used that to make images of Acorn Archimedes disks, which are 3.5 inch, and that system has a 3.5 inch drive. But unfortunately, that system is a little bit cramped on the inside. As you can see, this is an extremely cramped system. I disconnected the floppy drive already, but it's very difficult to reach that floppy connector there in the back, and there's just a lot of cables. It's just messy. I also have another Pentium 4 system up in the attic that I might actually consider using. They both run Windows XP, but I've read that Pentium 2 machines like this could also run Windows XP. So I might consider putting Windows XP on one of those compact flash cards and boot off that. So that is something I am contemplating with. As you can see here, I've built it into my system. It was quite a hassle with all the cable management. I had to swap around the CD drive and the zip drive in order to fit the IDE cables. Good thing I actually used a pretty generously long floppy cable with a cartridge connector adapter that proved to be really handy for the 3.5 inch drive. I really like those cartridge connectors over those 34 pin IDC connectors, they are a pain in the arse. But yeah, cartridge connectors are great. So, what I have here is an archive on my C drive. I'm going to show you copying some files from Dr. Halo. So first we're going to make a directory. So now I'm going to log onto the B drive. And now I have to go to the target directory here. Now I choose this asterisk F5 copy. Alright, as you can see, the files are copied just fine. And this way I copied actually a lot of disks already. So let's go back to the C drive. And as you can see, I have a lot of stuff here, a lot of old basic programs. And also a game here that's called Gunship. I made some copies of that. I bought that game a few years ago on a thrift store. It was really cheap, but I couldn't play it because I didn't have the 5¼-inch drive, but now I have, and I have made copies of both the discs. Still need to try that game in DOSBox because that game is a little bit too old-fashioned for this Pentium 2 machine. Gunship is a game that was primarily created for XT class machines, so it well, yeah, it doesn't work on this particular machine if I show you that. Well, that's what you get, and then it starts to glitch out. So yeah, Gunship really needs DOSBox and not a Pentium 2. Right, before I bought it, I did some investigation in this particular model, the JData JD380. I kind of started googling and I kind of got a little bit worried. The first thing I found was this forum post on this particular website, vcdfad.org, and someone mentions a problem with a JData JD380 not being able to read 360K disks, and that person didn't get it working. And something kind of worried me, and I think that information is just plain wrong and false. And that's something you should take into account, because it kind of got me off on the wrong start. So this thing here from CrescentFan got me worried. The person says, the JD380 is one of those weird high density floppy drives that will not read double density disks. Pin 2, which normally does the density select, isn't connected on the JD380. Well, I think that information is just plain wrong and false. That kind of got me confused and kind of sent you in the wrong direction. That is just not true. It will read them just fine because IBM computers and clone PCs always use single speed drives, but there exist dual speed drives of this particular model. And I think that person got something confused, because someone else says, the JD380 in my IBM 5170 reads 360K floppies. And if we start looking, on this website, -0°, there is something about the floppy format mathematics. And if you look at this 360K floppy in 1.2 megabyte drive, you will see that it actually just spins the drive at 360 RPM, just as it would do with high density disks. But a true double density drive actually speeds at 300 RPM. And here's the catch, the data rate. That's an interesting thing, because when you have a 360K in a 1.2 megabyte drive, The BIOS changes the data rate and it performs double stepping, and that's why it works. The IBM BIOS is smart, it doesn't need a dual speed drive, it can just use that single speed drive. And if we look at some data, here is a maintenance manual, which is not very helpful in fact. It doesn't really tell you much about the actual intrinsics of this drive, but there is actually a slightly different manual here. And this one mentions that there are two speed variants. You've got the model 1710, which is the high density only drive, the one that IBM and all the PCs use. And there's a version that is actually dual speed, and that dual speed version is not used in PCs. But at the end of this document is something important. It's this, technical tips. As you can see, the JD380-1711 made for IBM does not change speeds. These drive speed is set at 360 RPM. And then there's a different version, the one that's dual speed for Texas Instruments. And that one can run at both 300 RPM and 360 RPM. And this chart here, this is important. The IBM computers and also the clone PCs, they always use one of these three basically, or the 1736 that I have, which is a slightly newer version of those, and that's also a single speed drive, but it still does have the density select pin connected. But these dual speed drives you can pretty much ignore, those were not used by PCs. And now let's take a look at some photos. I found some photos on the internet, and this is of the particular C version that the person in that forum post apparently has a problem with dual density. And as you can see, there's no density select pin, but I don't think it's necessary. And this is an older drive, and this is the C version again. This, I think, is also a C version, and as you can see, there are no termination packs here. This is like the one that I have, it uses automatic termination. And this is one, that's an older one from the website where I bought it. This one was specifically made for IBM, and this comes from a very early unit, and it has this termination pack. But that termination pack is removed in later revisions. The later versions use automatic termination, just like a 3.5-inch drive, which is very convenient. But just be aware that there exist model differences of those drives. This is one that's exactly the same as I have, but this one was actually slightly cheaper, but was already bought by someone else. And this is actually the one that I bought from 1991. This is one that I have in my computer right now. This is that C model. And this is also a picture of a C model, and you can see that the circuit boards are different. Now let's take a look at some images on Google. And well, you can very easily see that there are many different variants of these drives around. They're all the JD380, they're all those high density drives. But yeah, be aware that there are version revision differences. But in general, the single speed ones are the ones that you should use in a PC. So yeah, I think I just had to mention that just to avoid confusion, and I hope I could clarify a few things about these drives. So I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.